Sickle cell anemia is a hereditary blood disorder characterized by the production of an abnormal form of hemoglobin, the protein in red blood cells that carries oxygen throughout the body. This condition is primarily associated with individuals of African, Mediterranean, Middle Eastern, and Indian descent, but it can occur in any ethnic group. This video covers the medical definition and provides a brief overview of this topic. So if you're ready, let's get into it. The hallmark of sickle cell anemia is the distortion of red blood cells into a sickle or crescent shape, a result of the abnormal hemoglobin that these cells contain. Normal red blood cells are flexible and round, allowing them to move easily through blood vessels. However, sickle-shaped cells are rigid and sticky, causing them to clump together and get stuck in small blood vessels. This leads to a myriad of complications as it impedes the flow of blood and, therefore, the supply of oxygen to different parts of the body. One of the most common and painful complications is a sickle cell crisis, which occurs when the flow of blood is obstructed. This can cause severe pain and damage to organs, bones, and muscles. These episodes can be unpredictable and vary in frequency and intensity among individuals. Apart from pain crises, individuals with sickle cell anemia are at increased risk for infections, delayed growth, vision problems, and strokes. The spleen, which helps filter infections from the blood, often becomes damaged due to the constant filtering of abnormal cells, making patients more susceptible to infections. The disease is inherited in an autosomal recessive pattern, meaning a child must inherit two sickle cell genes, one from each parent, to develop the condition. Those with only one sickle cell gene are carriers and usually do not show symptoms of the disease, but they can pass the gene to their children. Diagnosis of sickle cell anemia typically occurs in infancy or early childhood, often through routine newborn screening tests. Additional tests like hemoglobin electrophoresis can confirm the diagnosis. There is no universal cure for the disease, but treatments are available to alleviate symptoms, reduce complications, and improve quality of life. These include pain management strategies, blood transfusions, and hydroxyurea, a medication that can reduce the frequency of pain crises. In some cases, a bone marrow or stem cell transplant may offer a potential cure, but these procedures carry significant risks and are not suitable for all patients. Recent advances in gene therapy are showing promise as a potential treatment for sickle cell anemia. These experimental treatments involve manipulating the patient's genes to produce normal hemoglobin or to reactivate the production of fetal hemoglobin, which is naturally present in newborns and is effective in preventing sickling of the cells. Living with sickle cell anemia requires regular medical care and can be challenging for patients and their families. It involves managing pain, avoiding triggers for pain crises, and staying vigilant against infections. Comprehensive care from a team of specialists, including hematologists, pain management experts, and psychologists, can significantly improve outcomes and quality of life for those affected by this condition. If you want to support the channel, please like and subscribe. I would greatly appreciate it. And there should be some other helpful videos popping up on your screen right about now that I think you will enjoy. And just a quick reminder, we are not doctors. This video is for informational purposes only. Thank you so much for watching. Have a blessed day. And as always, breathe easy, my friend.